There are many regulatory developments in Latin America, for instance in Brazil, Chile, and very recently in Argentina. Exciting, but what can we expect? It's like trying to hit a piñata wearing a blindfold. Therefore, it's superb that today we can discuss the developments and expectations for chemical control legislation in Latin America with Daniel Rios and Roland Bircher. Welcome. Both of you are part of the Latin America Regulatory Cooperation Forum established by ABIQUIM, the Brazilian Industry Association. One of the aims of the forum is to encourage local authorities to establish regulatory cooperation. Daniel, how much cooperation do you already see and how are you as a forum trying to support this?
Thank you, Tia. As you know, in Latin America, we have trade blocs, Mercosur and the community. However, chemicals management was never part or not usually part of these discussions. The aim of our forum is to engage the industry in those discussions as one of the main stakeholders to contribute to good practice and regulations that are consistent with the society and the resource of those countries.
Okay. Roland, can you give in a bird's eye view the regulatory implementation level in Latin America?
Well, as mentioned by Daniel, I think the international UN conventions, Rotterdam, Stockholm, Basel, Minamata, were the main focus of regulatory framework type legislations or implementations we had. In addition to that, we had, based on the situation of Latin America with the drug problem, we had legislation on drug precursors and also pesticides, which obviously have a lot of use in Latin America. But beyond that, we didn't really discover any, or we didn't really have any integrated regulatory framework or chemical framework legislations. So very recently, governments have started to publish public consultations as Brazil, Colombia, and Chile, and others are to follow. So we clearly see a movement now.
And do you see some good practices of regulatory cooperation that are bridging the current differences between the countries and creating a kind of similar level playing field for industry?
Yes, there are many regulatory cooperation initiatives around the world. We'd like to point out, for example, the Asian Regulatory Cooperation initiative that's very interesting. It's an opportunity of looking for practical and science-based and also consistent regulatory frameworks that can protect human health and environment and also avoid barriers to trade. So
basically, there's a good cooperation level in Brazil, and you're looking a little bit also to what happened already in Asian countries, how they developed over the last decade.
Yes, definitely. I mean, the harmonization as good as it gets. Latin America countries are pretty much all of them aligned with the Purple Book.
Which version?
Between 1 and 6. And so they are aligned in most of the aspects. Many of them refer directly to the Purple Book, but we clearly see local differences, and I think we will always have them over the next few years. What we just been discussing with the Chile government in the public consultation on their GHS norm is that they are going, or by suggestion, they are going to apply the CLP building blocks.
Okay.
And cutoffs, whereas most of the region is using the full set of building blocks.
What we recommend that when a country decides which building blocks they are going to assign to the regulation, they take into consideration the building blocks chosen by their main trade partners, so they can avoid technical barriers to trade.
What are your main trade partners?
Well, he referred to Chile, that the main trade partners is China, Brazil, and US.
Mm-hmm. The forum is an industry initiative. Daniel, you're based in Argentina. Roland, you're based in Brazil. Are all Latin America countries already represented in your forum?
Well, at this point, unfortunately not. So we have to say this is a very new initiative, and our objective is clearly to get participation from the whole region, because this is essential. I mean, we want to build a dialogue with the local governments. They have their proper initiatives for harmonization. But then on the industry association side, we're not quite there yet. So I think it's very important to get all the countries on board, get specialists from all the countries on board to discuss possible best practices and leverage these to various other countries.
Very good. And final question for you, Daniel. What is the strategy of the forum to enhance regulatory cooperation in the region?
The most important part of our initiative is to strengthen the dialogue between industry to industry, government to government, and can have a common forum of discussions, especially in the next year that we are building those regulations, because we know after the regulations are in place, it's much more difficult to make them compatible or harmonized.
Thank you for these concluding remarks. Good to see that industry is not turning a blind eye on necessary developments in Latin America. The forum is actively participating to move the process ahead. This might not yet result in regulatory consistency in the region today, but if impractical and costly regulations can be avoided and a sound system is implemented, I think it's fair to say, mañana is soon enough for us.